have here is the Hercules Force. And it has 15 amp high output motor. And it is 1,000 beats per minute. Although I think the specs are less. It says like 950, although I could be wrong. Anyway, we're here at Gnarly Barley Brewing. We are putting in some beer cellars. Enough room for 7 more beer cellar tanks. And I'll show that in a little while, but we are trying out the Hercules jackhammer, electric jackhammer. And the reason I'm buying a new jackhammer is because my cargo trailer got robbed about 2 months ago. So I've been replacing things as I've needed them. I got robbed for two of about just over $20,000 worth of stuff. Although I got a lot of it back because at pawn shops. So if you were the ones who robbed me and you want to rob me again, please next time bring all my stuff to a pawn shop. That would help me out a lot. Or if anyone else wants to rob me, just bring it all to a pawn shop. I prefer that because it's easier to get it back. Alright. And I can go over some more specifics about being robbed and insurance on another video, because that is super important. Super important. What to do and what not to do. Alright, so this is a jackhammer. I'm about to open this bad boy up. It's a 1 1/8 hex breaker hammer with maximum vibration. It was about $599. It was just under $600 before taxes. So yeah. Unfortunately, I bought a chisel. It comes with two chisels. I wouldn't do that again. But it weighs 66 pounds and it puts out 58 joules of energy each beat, I guess. So it's supposed to be comparable to both brute and one of the other big brands. We'll see how it works out. I didn't buy the warranty because you get no warranty. Harbor free. We'll see. Tell you what, the first time I bought equipment, when I first started, I bought used. I didn't buy high. I bought high end, but I bought it used. I bought from rental places. Which, looking back, just starting out, as I've been buying things that have been stolen, I've been buying harbor freight, something else, some other one, buying, whatever. Been buying different places. I probably bought more cheap tools than I did the first time, and then as I break the cheap tools up, I'll buy more expensive tools if it makes sense. So, you gotta consider things being broken, equipment being abused, not maintained, and being stolen. You can't really just go out and buy the best of the best. But for instance, one of the things that I got back that was stolen was a Honda, looking at it right now, FIEU 7000IS, $5,000 generator. And I was very upset because I wasn't going to replace it with the same. I was going to buy a cheaper one for that exact reason. So anyway, I got that back. I got a smaller generator back, a 2000, Honda 2000 suitcase. Anyway, I got a bunch of stuff back, so I was glad about that. But anyway, let's go ahead and get this off. So there is. There's the item number for you right there. It's 56407. 56407. We have a tube of lube. Owner's manual. Another blade?
Yep.
Put that one back on. That one's not getting going. Yeah, it is. This one's not. Have you checked in tomorrow? That's heavy. Put it on backwards, see what happens.
It ain't gonna cut good.
Well. We have two sets of brushes and lube and grease. Got a chisel here. Got a the shank has the flat chisel, like a about 1 inch, maybe a quarter. 1.5 maybe. Clean your chisels off, clean your bits, your shanks. Collarless bit instruction. Collared bit instructions. So there's two different instructions though. The one comes with this collarless and this one's not bought half a dollar. Usually I've had a brute. I had a brute get stolen. So I'm gonna take this off and put it in the bag. Automatic maintenance system. Tool automatically shuts off when brush placement needed. Follow manual instructions to provide preventive maintenance, including brush placement and lubrication. Has a 16-foot cord. Huh. So on the cord it has more instructions. It says clean loading end a bit, then lubricate with grease. So before you put a bit in there, you clean it and then lubricate it. And then when you take one off, obviously you take one off, you clean it so it can be lubricated. It won't collect a bunch of dirt on it. So that's what that's for. Cleaning bits. Alright, let's get this.
Feels good. Feels like a boot. Let's see.
Pull locking level, pull locking lever open about 30 to 40 degrees as shown between, below. So, follow this bit. And this is for the collarless. And two, pull this locking lever towards housing the locking bit as shown below. Pull on the bit to check security of lock before opening. It has the same. Let's see. So here's the difference. When you have a collar, you close it towards the bit. And when you don't have a collar, you close it towards the tool. Up. Collar. Down. Okay. No collar up. Collar closed down. Okay. Yes. I can't believe we're at 14 minutes. Jesus, I can talk, huh? There it is. Rock and roll, huh? Rock and roll. All right. Let's see, don't crush it. Keep away from moving machines. Well, you'd think they would try to think on the cord, they would let you know what kind of amps you would need. Oh, there we go. It's written on the cord. 14 AWG. Okay. Of course, it's a 15 amp motor, so. So, alright, I'll try to get some footage of me using this here at the brewery, Gnarly Barley Brewing, here in Hammond, Louisiana. Alright.
Alright, so coming to you from Gnarly Barley Brewing in Hammond. And we are adding on to the beer cellar here. We're going to put in 4 more of these tanks. I'm going to give them room for 7. We're having another 7. More available space for another 7, but just put it in 4 for now. So that's it right there. We saw cut that yesterday. There, and we saw cut the curb. We'll be breaking that off. And there's HERCULES right there. We're gonna be breaking out just enough for a trench. It's 22 inches by 54 foot, and then whatever the outlet is right here. Go outside, it's gonna get a little fun. Warning, these brews have a chance to have a they're like a little mouth.
I don't think I would have got it.